This image has seen better days, but not for long. In this tutorial, we'll restore it step by step, blending AI tools with Photoshop to reconstruct lost details. By the end, it'll look like it was never damaged. Let's jump in. First, I'll bring my image into Photoshop and crop it down to focus on the main subject. Now I'll head over to Filter, select Neural Filters, and right here in the Restoration section, we've got this sneaky little wizard, Photo Restoration. Now turn this on, then on the right side panel, you will see two sliders and adjustment options. Now I'll slightly increase the scratch reduction to 5%. Then it will process the effect. Once it's done, you'll see an option for output at the bottom. I'll set it to new layer so the original image stays untouched. Then I'll hit OK. Now I'll click on the panel menu icon and then duplicate the layer. This keeps a backup of the restored image so we can tweak it further if needed. Now again, I'll go to the filter menu, navigate to the sharpen group and choose Unsharp Mask. In the settings, I'll set the amount to 75%. The radius to around 6 pixels, and the threshold to 1 level. This will improve the overall sharpness of the image. Next, I'll duplicate this layer and change the blending mode of the new layer to multiply. This will darken the image, enhancing the contrast and details. Now I'll click on the adjustment layer icon and add a levels adjustment layer. Now I'll slightly drag the white slider towards the left. This will brighten the image while maintaining the details. After that, I'll use the white point picker and click on a white area in the image. This will make Photoshop automatically adjust the levels, correcting the color balance. Once that's done, hold Shift and click on Layer 1 to select them all. Now click on this Layer panel icon and select a new group with layers. Now I'll duplicate this group to track my progress. And finally merge this group. Now I'll grab the Spot Healing Brush tool and clean up any remaining imperfections. I'll speed this up, so sit back and enjoy the process. Okay, so now I've cleaned up the image pretty well, but there's still some work left. Let's take it a step further. I'll create a duplicate of this layer, and then I'll go to Filter. Under the Noise group, I'll choose Dust and Scratches. Here, I'll set the radius to 1 pixel and hit OK. This will help smooth out any tiny imperfections while keeping the details intact. And if you want, you can also use Generative Fill to clean up or modify the borders of the frame. This tool is seriously impressive. In some cases, it can do an absolutely fantastic job, saving you a lot of time compared to manual retouching. After using Generative Fill, merge these layers together so that future adjustments apply seamlessly to the entire image. Now, go to Filter and select Neural Filters. We'll use the Colorize filter to restore natural and realistic colors to the image. If you haven't downloaded it yet, do that first. Once applied, Photoshop will instantly add color based on its AI predictions. Here, you can also tweak the adjustment settings if you want. Once you are done, set the output to New Color Layer before hitting OK. This keeps the color adjustments separate from the original so we can refine them without affecting the base image. Now, I noticed some color imperfections, where the woman's hair color is blending too much with the greenery in the background. To fix this, I'll use the eyedropper tool to pick the correct shade and the brush tool to manually adjust those areas. And finally, the image is revived. Here's a quick before and after comparison. The colors are back, most imperfections are cleared, and we've restored much of the original detail. This is where a standard photo restoration would typically end, true to the original without adding anything extra. However, if you are comfortable taking some creative liberties and adding new details to the image, we can take the restoration to the next level with AI. And for that, I'm using Leonardo AI. This is the homepage. Just click Launch App and sign in with any of your accounts. Once you're in, you'll land on the app, where they give you 150 tokens per day. More than enough for cooking up some AI magic. Now, head straight to the Universal Upscaler. Drop your image here. And for free users, the only available upscale mode is Legacy. For the upscaler style, I'm picking General, since my image doesn't resemble the other options. Now, check out this Creativity Strength slider. The more you crank it up, the more AI starts filling in details from a pure imagination. And yes, that includes faces too. But don't panic. I'll make sure your ancestors don't end up looking like AI-generated strangers, while everything else gets crispy. Now just below that, we've got the Upscale Multiplier. It maxes out at 2x, but of course, that's locked behind a paywall. Not that we care, because 1x is all we need. Now, here's the game plan. We're going to create two variations. First, set the creativity strength to level 8 and upscale the image. Then, do the same for level 10. Once you've got both the images, rename them for better organization. But wait, AI gave the faces an identity crisis. Let's fix that with another AI tool called Face26. And as always, links in the description. Once you're on the site, click Get Started, then hit the profile icon and sign up using Google or Facebook. After that, you'll land on the main interface. Now, just upload your image. In the Tools section, you'll find Enhancer V1 right in the middle. It's free to use once, but after that, a watermark appears. Now I'll hit Enhancer V1 and let it process. Once it's done, the face is back from the dead, beautifully unblurred and looking crisp as ever. And if you're using it for the first time, just download the image. The watermark will be removed automatically. All right, time to flex those Photoshop skills. Dump everything into Photoshop. And here's the Leonardo AI lineup. Level 3 strength, barely any change. Then level 4. And level 5. The details are leveling up, but the faces, they're out here rewriting their own history. Now I just need level 8 and 10 to complete this evolution. So I'll put the remaining images in a group. First, ensure that all the images are perfectly centered. I like the man's outfit from level 10 and the woman's outfit from level 8. To blend them, I'll add a layer mask to all three images. Then from the level 10 image, I'll erase that extra dude because a woman was supposed to be there. All right, grab your brush tool, set it to black, and start masking. Stay sharp around those edges. Now I'll switch to level 8 and mask out the faces, keeping it all clean and precise. All right, it's looking better, but some areas need a full-on fix, like the woman's hand, which is a total mess, and the pants, where the fabric suddenly changes. Oh, and the man? Yeah, he's just floating mid-air with no ground beneath him. So, to fix all this, we'll use Generative Fill. I'll speed this up, so sit back and enjoy the process. And there it is, fully restored, and pulled back into our timeline. From this to this. Crazy transformation, right? But I didn't stop there. I also did some color grading and camera raw filter to refine the final look. And here's how it turned out. If you love the restoration, drop a like. And if you're curious about how I created these cool illustrations using this image, let me know in the comments. I'll make a full tutorial on it. Make sure to subscribe if you found this helpful, and drop a like to support the channel. I'll see you in the next one.